गुड आफ्टरनून एवरी वन, आई एम गौरव गुप्ता एज यूअर मैथमेटिक्स टीचर। दिस इज आवर थर्ड लेक्चर ऑन क्लास 9 चैप्टर फर्स्ट। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल सॉल्व एक्सरसाइज 1.5 एंड 1.6 इन अ सिंगल शॉट। सो दिस विल बी गोइंग टू वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग बिकॉज इन दिस लेक्चर वी हैव टू कवर थ्रू एक्सरसाइज। हाउ वी विल कवर, सो बी रेडी टू डू your exercise. I am taking our exercise 1.5. First question is, please read the statement. Classify the following are rational or irrational number. It means our first question is very simple. What we have to do? Just we have to write either our number is rational or irrational, and we already know about different properties of the rational and irrational, and I hope you understand all the properties. If you understand this property, then this type of question becomes very easy, because such type of question will be asked one marks question, as well as such type of question will be put in your competitive exam purpose. So if you crack the competitive exam, then you have to know and to learn and to remember also all these properties, then this such type of question becomes very easy. Please make a look. We have to classify which one number is rational and which one number is irrational. It's very simple. I am writing here these three properties. We already discussed in our first lecture. I write all these properties. So the question one is same, based on these properties. How it is? Please make a look. Six, whether the number is rational or irrational. Our first number is 2 minus root 5. It means we have to subtract or we have to do difference of two number. One number is 2. What is 2? 2 is your rational number. And what is root 5? Root 5 is your irrational number. It means we are taking a difference of one rational number and one irrational number. And what will be the property? Please make a look. I am writing here 1. 1 is the first property. What it say? Please make a read. The sum or the difference of a rational and an irrational number. It means we are taking here difference. Match with difference. So whatever the sum or the difference of a rational and a irrational number always gives a irrational number. Again, difference of a rational and an irrational number will always an irrational number. So our first answer is irrational number. Now look at the second question. 3 plus root 23, it means the same question here. Firstly, you read this 3 plus root 23, same as first. 3 is your rational number and 23 is your irrational number. So, rational plus irrational becomes irrational number. So, this is your irrational number and square root of 23, which is also irrational number. It means we are taking difference, because here negative sign indicates difference. It means we are taking difference of two irrational number, because this is also irrational number and this one is also irrational number. And what's the property of two irrational number? Look at property third. If we add, subtract, multiply, divide two irrational number, the resultant may be rational or irrational. It means there is a confusion, because the number may be rational or irrational. And how we can calculate this number is either rational or irrational? We have to solve it. Solve it. We get 3 plus root 23. Negative 23. Root 23 will cancel out with root 23. It means we get 3. And what is 3 is? 3 is your rational number. So please make a note. This one is your rational number. Now look at the third question. Again, this is the form of multiplication or quotient. It is the form of quotient. And what's the number? 2 square root of 7. Because every square root numbers are irrational. That's why this is your irrational number. And 7 root 7 is also irrational number. It means we are taking a quotient of 2 irrational number. And what will be the result? Make a property second. The product or the quotient of a non-zero rational number with an irrational number is an irrational number. But third property, in this we have to take third property, not the property second, because these two numbers are irrational and here division comes. So the again the number may be rational or irrational, because here both the numbers are irrational. So we have to simplify this. We are clearly visible. The numerator carry root 7 and denominator carry also root 7. It means root 7 will be cancelled out with the root 7. And what we will got? We got 2. And what is 2 is? 2 is your rational number. So answer is your rational number. Now look at fourth. Here 1 is your rational number and division form is means quotient or division form. Square root of 2 is your irrational number. Now look at the properties again. The product or the quotient, because in this we are taking quotient. Quotient of a rational number with irrational number. So quotient means division form. Rational number and irrational form. What will be the answer? The answer is irrational. The product or a quotient of a non-zero rational number with an irrational number is always an irrational number. So answer is your irrational number. Now look at your fifth part. 2 into pi. What is 2? 2 is your rational number. And what is pi? Pi is your irrational number, because its value 3.14 and so on up to this one is your irrational. It means we are taking a multiplications. 2 into pi means we are doing multiplication. 2 into pi. So again 2 is your rational and pi is your irrational. So in this it also includes product also. So product of rational and irrational always be irrational numbers. So answer is our irrational. So it becomes very easy. So that's why I am focused to remember all the properties, because if you learn the property, then such type of question gives 100% marks in few seconds. That is the quickest way to solve such type of question. There is no difficulties in this type of question. It's very easy. Please make a note first, then we are try to do our next question. Please make a note first. Now we are going to take our next question. This question is very simple, because we already did such type of question in our first lecture also, because this question is also based on the property of the square roots. How we solve that? Please make a look. We have to simplify this, means if we have to solve and get a simplified answer, then how we will do? All the terms are in terms of square root, and we know how we multiply and how we divide this number. Our first number is, look at this number. It means we have to multiply. Firstly, you have to multiply your first number. Then you have to multiply it with second number. Then what's the result? 3 into 2, we get 6 plus. Now, 3 into root 2, because 3 is your rational number and 2 is square root number. So it will remain as it is. Now we have to do same as our second number. Now root 3 is multiplied by 2. What's the result? 2 root 3. Again, this number is multiplied with another number, root 2. Now this number is root 3 multiplied root 2. Simplify it. 6 plus, because here is square root of 2 and this one is square root of 3. It means this one is donkey and this one is horse. They cannot be add. So we write as it is, 3 root 2 plus 2 root 3. Now we have to apply the property. It means if the two square roots comes in multiplication form, then we can replace the two square root by a single square root and the numbers are multiplied. So in this we make a single square root and the numbers are multiplied. 3 into 2, which is equal to 6. Again check, this number, all numbers are different. If all numbers are different, then how we can add? Because it's a monkey with add, with donkey with add, cat with add, dog. That is not possible. because add or subtract will be the same, either dog dog, donkey donkey, horse horse. So it means this number will not be solved further. That is your final answer. Now solve this. Look at this question. The terms are same. 3, 3, root 3, root 3. But the difference is only the sign. Here sign is positive and here sign is negative. And we know if the two terms are same, only the difference is negative. And what's the identity we have to use? So the most important identity, a square minus b square. Apply this. What's the identity? A plus b, a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. If we compare this, a is equal to 3 and b is equal to root 3. Now put it here, because this term has equal to this term. What's the value of a is 3? So square of 3 negative. Now we have to do square of b. B is your root 3. So we have to do square of root 3, and square of 3 is 9. And we know what's the property of square root. If we do square of a square root term, then square root will be cut with square and we get only the number. So we get only the number. Square will cancel out with square root, but we will get 9 minus 3, which is equal to 6. This one is your final answer. Now look at the third question. It is simple, because whole square, and you know what's the whole square property is, a square plus b square plus me 2ab. Now apply this. A plus b whole square is equal to a square plus b square plus me 2 multiplied by b. Apply this. Here a is root 5 and b is root 2. So put it here. First one is a. A is value is root 5. We have to take square. Now we have to take b, and the b value has root 2. So we again the square plus 2 into a. A is again root 5 and b is root 2. Now it's the same property. Square will cancel out with square root. We get 5. Square will cancel out with square root. We get 2 plus 2. And 2 square roots makes a single square root. 5 into 10 to 10, we get a 10. Now 5 plus 2 we can add, which is equal to 7. 7 plus 2 root 10, because this number will not be added, because 2 is together with square root of 3. So it becomes a different number and this becomes a different number. So they cannot be added. So our final answer is this. Now look at our fourth part. Again look, the terms are same. Now apply the same property. A minus B, A plus B, which is equal to A square minus B square. What is A? A is root 5. What is B? Is root 2. And sign is negative. Again square is cancel out square root. We get only 5. Square root cancel out with square. We get 2. 5 minus 2 is equal to 3. I hope you understand this question, because this question is very simple. We already did such type of question. Please make a note first. So please look at our third question. What it says? It's very lengthy question, but the solution is only 3 or 4 statements. So we have to write a statement, and that statement is your final answer. Firstly, you have to understand what's the question I want to ask you. The question says that, recall, revise the number pi. Pi is defined as you know, pi is your irrational number. But the statement, what it say? It say pi can be defined as the ratio of circumference. We have to denote it by circumference by c of a circle. 2 means we are dividing, we are taking to ratio of its diameter. It means we are talking two terms and we have to take its ratio. You know this one is your circle, and if we measure this length, which is called outer boundary of a circle. You can say that length of outer boundary of a circle is called circumference. Here we denoted circumference as C. Now the term is diameter, and we know what's the diameter? Twice of the radius. Firstly, you have to write what is circumference. We know circumference is equal to 2 pi r. That is the formula to calculate the circumference of a circular circle, 2 pi r. Now we are talking about diameter. Diameter is, this one is your center. If we draw a line passing through the center, a line passing through the center and cut at two points on the circle, then it is called a diameter. It means this one is your radius and this is also your radius. So diameter is basically twice of radius. Diameter, we are denoting diameter as D, which is equal to 2r. Now please read the statement. Defined as, it means we are defining as pi. Pi is defined as the ratio. It means we are dividing ratio of circumference. It means about circumference of a circle. 2 means we have divide diameter. So here pi defined as, and you know what is circumference? Circumference is 2 pi r divided by 2 r. So you know we are covered 2 pi r. What is basically 2 pi r? Is the circumference, and which is your rational number. This one is your rational number. Also 2 r, this one is your also rational number. So according to property, the ratio of two rational number gives us rational number. It means we get a rational number. So this makes pi as a rational number. According to this statement, pi is a rational number, but we know pi is an irrational number. So how we can differentiate this? So this seems to be contradict. It means this statement opposite to us, that we are considering pi as a irrational, but this statement can say pi is a rational number. So this seems to be contradict to this fact. It means this statement is opposite. We clearly seen that this statement say pi is a rational number, and we clearly understood, and we already discussed pi is a irrational number. Then the question said, how will you resolve this contradiction? It means we have to give the answer why it is your irrational number. So the answer is, whenever we measure tape, when we are measure the length of circumference or the diameter, which are the rational number, and using scale or tape for measurement of your rational number gives us approximate value, not the exact value. Again I repeat, the tape and using tape or scale, if you measure the rational number, then it will give an approximate value, not the exact value. So this is your approx rational number. So that's why it is not a pure rational number. So that's why pi remains irrational number according to your mathematical statement. Again I repeat it, because if you measure from tape or length, you get an approximate rational number. So that's why we are calculating here approximate rational number as a pi, but not the exact values of a pi. So that's why pi remains an irrational number. According to this, we get only the approximate value. According to mathematical statement, pi is irrational number is correct. So please make a note first, then I will write the whole statement in terms of return. Please make a note. I write the reason. Using scale or tape, we get only the approximate rational number. As a result of our measurement, whenever we do measurements, we get only the approximate value of the rational number. So according to statement, that gives us, I am talking about this statement, which gives us approximate values of the pi. It gives us approximate values. Approx values, not the exact value. Not the exact value. So according to mathematically, pi will always be a irrational number. So we remove our contradiction. Please make a note first. So our next question is question number 4. We already did in our first video. So before to this video, please make a look first video, then you clearly understand. I make a separate video to represent your square root of decimal integer points. So now we are doing our question number 5th. Is rationalize the denominator of the following, and you know what's the rationalization, because in 9th class it's a first step that comes rationalized in your syllabus. So here I am writing what's the meaning and need of the rationalization, why we are doing rationalization, what's the benefit of the rationalization. Question is this: are you locate 1 upon by root 2 on a number line? The question is that are you able to locate 1 upon the square root of 2 on a number line? That it is not, because answer is no, we cannot represent it on a number line. But if we do rationalization, then it is possible to locate this. How? Please make a look. What's the process of rationalization? Rationalization can be do numerator as well as denominator. But in this question, what is asked to you? Rationalization is applied on the denominator. But you remember, this rationalization can apply both the numerator as well as denominator. Most probably we apply the denominator terms, because in the denominator terms, if carry square root number, that makes the calculation so typical. So if we remove the denominator terms, then we get only the numerator terms, but it's very easy to simplify. That's why we are doing rationalization. What's the process of rationalization? Is simply, if you have a single number in terms of square root, so you have to multiply and divide by the same number is called the rationalization. Please make a look. Our number is 1 upon me square root of 2. Now do rationalization. How we do? Multiply and divide by root 2. Multiply and divide by root 2. Now multiply this. This is our term. We have to multiply as well as we have to divide. What we will got? 1 into square root of 2, which is equal to square root of 2. And square root of 2 into square root of 2 is equal to 2. Because if two square roots come in multiplication form, then single square roots comes, and 2 into 2, which is equal to 4. And what's the square root of 4 is 2. So we get 2. It means this indicates, what indicates? This indicates that this number is in between 0 and root 2. Because this indicate, what it indicates? I am writing here. This can be written as this can be written as 1 by 2 of root 2. 1 by 2 means half of root 2. So this number is located between 0 and root 2. We already locates the root 2 on a number line. So if we make a bisect, then we can easily locate 1 these number on the number line, because it lies where it lies. It lies in between 0 and root 2. So please make a note. Now our question first is 1 upon the root 7. So do rationalize as we have already did. What we are doing? Multiply and divide by root 7, because the denominator term is 7. We get 1 by root 7 multiply root 7, and root 7 into 1, which is equal to square root of 7, and root 7 into root 7, which is equal to 7. This one is your final answer. Now look at the second part. In this we have not a single term, but we have a term which in forms of sum or difference of two terms. Again I repeat, in this case the denominator does not carry a single term, but it carries a sum or difference of two terms. Then what you have to do? You have to multiply and divide the denominator terms by changing the sign. Again I repeat, you have to multiply and divide the same term by changing the sign. If sign is positive, then you have to take sign negative, otherwise you have to negative, then you will have to take positive. In this case, what we have sign? Negative. It means we have to do. So you write here rationalize. What do you mean by rationalize? Multiply and divide by root 7, at negative sign we have to take sign positive sign. Now apply this. 1 upon me root 7 minus root 6. If you multiply root 7 plus me root 6, root 7 plus me root 6. Please make a look. If you multiply these sum by 1, then what we will get? We got the same term, because if any number is multiplied by 1, we get the same number. So we get here root 7 plus me root 6. But here we have to note, look at the terms. The terms are same as we already did in our questions. Second, a minus b and a plus b. What's the result? A square minus b square. So we get here, first term is your root 7, root 7 square. Second term is your root 6, root 6 square. What's the result? Root 7 plus me root 6, and square cancel out the square, we get 7. And square cancel out the square, we get 6. So here we get root 7 plus root 6, and 7 minus 6, which is equal to 1. So our final answer is root 7 plus root 6. This is your final answer. You have to write their property using identity. What's the identity? A minus B, A plus B, which is equal to A square minus B square. Please make a note, then we have to do our next question. Now we have to take our third part, which says 1 upon me square root of 5 plus me square root of 2. Apply rationalization. Rationalization. What we have to do? Multiply and divide. What we have to do? Multiply and divide by the same term, root 5 and root 2, by changing the sign. Here sign is positive, and we have to take sign negative. Now apply on this. 1 upon me root square root of 5 plus me square root of 2, multiply square root of 5 minus square root of 2, square root of 5 minus square root of 2. Multiply and divide. Now this, if you multiply by 1, we get the same term, root 5 minus root 2. In every case, rationalization, we get only one identity, a square minus b square, a minus b and a plus b. Again, a plus b and a minus b. And what we will got? We got a square minus b square. Right here identity. A minus b, a plus b, which is equal to a square minus b square. Now solve this. What we will got? Square root of 5 minus square root of 2. And square will cancel out square root. What we will got? 5. Again square root will be cut by the square. We got 2. And the final answer is root square root of 5 minus square root of 2 divided by 3. This one is your final answer. Now apply on this question. Now we have to multiply and divide by square root of 7 plus 2. We have changed sign, plus minus change is positive. 1 upon the square root of 7 minus 2 multiply square root of 7 plus 2 square root of 7 plus 2. We are multiplying that by changing the sign. Multiply and divide. Now the same process, if we divide by 1, what we will put? Square root of 7 plus 2. Here again, a minus b, a plus b. A square minus b square. And what's the result? Roots 2, 7 plus 2. And square root of 7 will be cut by 7. Minus square of 2 is 4. We got square root 7 plus 2. 7 minus 4 which is equal to 3, and this will be the your answer. I hope you understand this. Because rationalization is a step, and it's very important. It applies so many questions in either in class 10th, 11th, 12th, everywhere. So keep in mind, rationalization is your main tool to simplify your typical question. Please make a look first. So be ready to do your exercise 1.6. I said already before to start the video, this video is going to be more interesting, because in this video we have to do two exercises in only 1 hour. So be ready to do and do practice more and more questions so that this exercise becomes very easy to do. Thus, this exercise is totally as you done in your class 8th. Same as in your class 8th, what you have to do? You read all this property. This is called the laws of exponent. Means, what are the rules of your exponent terms? This is m n. This is the power term is called your exponent terms. What's the first rule is? Please make a look fast. A. If there is two terms which are in terms of multiplications, and they have the powers difference. Here is m. There is n. So if the base, you can see that this is base and this is power. If you got same base, then power will be add. So we get same base and power will be add. M plus n, which is equal to m plus n. Take an example. For example, 2 raised to power 3 into 2 raised to power 4. They are multiplied. They have the same base. So we can write as same base, power will be add. 3 plus 4, which is equal to 7. I am taking another example. 3 raised to power 4. 3 raised to the power 9, then what will be the answer? Because the base are same and they are multiplied. So we get a base 3 and power will be add. 4 plus 9, which is equal to 13. So we get answer 13. Now look at the second property. If a term base into power, again the term has power, then what will we do? The powers get multiplied. Please make a look. Here, the power base is A and power is M. And the whole term has a power of N. So power will be multiplied. M into N. Base will remain same. Power will be multiplied. Look at this. If this is square of 3 and this one, the whole term has a power of 4. It means the base has power into power. So power will be multiplied. Base will remain same. 3 as it is. And power will multiply 2 into 4, which is equal to 8. That's your final answer. Look at another example. If I have 2 raised to power 3 raised to the power 5, what will be the answer? Because power to the power, power will be multiplied. So you get the answer 2 raised to power 3 into 5, 15. That is your final answer. Now look at the third property. We say if the two terms, one is numerator and second one is denominator, have the same base but the power difference. Have the base is same, A, but the power difference. And if you have to take, if you write in terms of numerator, then you simply subtract m minus n. Numerator power minus denominator power. So look at this. 4 is to power 7, 4 is to power 2, means base are same. Then power will be subtract. So we have write 7, power will subtract 7 minus 2, which is equal to 5. Now look at our third, fourth property. If they are different base, but the powers are same. Look at this. M, M, power will be same, but the base are different. Here base is A and here base is B. If the powers are same, then base will be multiplied. So look at this example. 3 raised to the power 6. 3 raised to the power 3. It means, sorry, I am taking here 4. 3 raised to the power 6. 4 raised to the power 6. Powers are same. Then what we have to do? Base we have to multiply. Then what will be the answer? 3 into 4, 12. And power will be same. I am giving another example. 3 raised to the power 7 and 5 raised to the power 7. Again, the power is same, then base is multiplied. Then what will be the answer? 3 into 5, 15. The whole power is 7. That is your answer. Please make a look, because our whole exercise is totally based on these four laws of exponent terms. Please make a note first. So this one is your first question of exercise 1.6. Find 64 raised to the power 1 by 2. Please keep in mind, whenever you try to solve such type of question, or you have to do simplifications in such type of question, the power is in terms of 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 2 by 3, 7, and so on. You have to look the denominator part of the power. Here the denominator part of the power is 2. You have to focus on this. If it is 2, it means you have to write the terms given in the denominator. You have to change as that of same power. For example, here the base, here the term is 2 in the denominator. So we have to change 64 in terms of power of 2. So what we can write 64 as a power of 2? Square of 8. So we can write as 64 can be written as square of 8, because square of 8 is 64. Now we apply the property power into power. Then what's the rule? Power will be multiplied and base will be remain same. Means base remains same and power will multiply. To multiply, 2 multiply 1 upon 2. 2 will be cancelled out with 2. But we will got 8 raised to the power 1 and 8 raised to the power 1, which is equal to 8. So this one is your answer. Look at the second question. Here the term in the denominator is 5. It means we have to take a base which has a power of 5. Then what will be the base? 2. Because if you multiply 2, 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, 2 into 2, 4 into 2, 8 into 2, 16 into 2, 32. It means this can be written as 2 raised to the power 5. So in this, the denominator part carries 5. So we have to write a term in terms of base whose power is 5. So 32 can be written as 2 raised to the power 5 and the whole power is 1 by 5. Now again, power into power, so we have to write base as it is and power will be multiplied. So this will be 2 raised to the power 5 multiplied with 1 upon 5. 5 will cancel out, but we will got only 1. So 5 raised to the power 1, which is equal to 5. This one is your final answer. Now look at this, 3. It means we have to change 125 in terms of term. Any base whose power is 3. And what's the term? Just imagine, cube of 5. 5 into 5, 25 into 5, 125. So we can write as 125 is cube of 5, and this term remains same 1 by 3. Again, power will be multiplied, 3 multiply 1 upon 3, 3 will cancel out with 3. But we will go 5 raised to the power 1, so answer is 5. Please make a note. So let's we have to go our next question. Question number is 2. What we have to do? 9 raised to the power 3 by 2. You have to think the same. What's the denominator terms? It carries 2. It means we have to change that term whose base may be anyone, but the power is 2. So 9 can be written as square of 3. So this can be written as square of 3. The whole power will be remains 3 by 2. Again the power will be multiplied. We get 3 raised to the power 2 multiplied 3 upon by 2. 2 will cancel out with 2. What we will got? 3 raised to the power 3. And what's the result? 3 into 3 into 3. Cube of 3 is 27. So our answer is 27. Look at the second question. 32 raised to the power 2 by 5. Look at the denominator part. It carries 5. So we have to change in terms of power of 5. What's the term? 2 raised to the power 5. Because we already did 32 is equal to 2 raised to the power 5. So we can write as 2 raised to the power 5. And the power is 2 by 5. Now the powers will be multiplied. We get 2 raised to the power 5 multiplied 2 upon 5. 5 will cancel out with 5. And what will be the results? We get 2 raised to the power 2. And what's the square of 2 is 4. It means 4 is your final answer. Now look at the third part, 16. Look at the term. Denominator terms is 4. It means we have to change the term which have a power of 4. What's the term? 2 raised to the power 4, because 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, which is equal to 16. So make a right, 2 raised to the power 4. Again the power is 3 by 4. Power will be multiplying. 2 raised to the power 4 multiplied 3 by 4. 4 cancel out with 4. And what we will got? We got 2 raised to the power 3. And what's the answer is? Cube of 2 is 8. Now look at the fourth question, but the main point is here the term is negative, and you know what's how we can remove the term sign? By changing the term. If the term carry negative sign in the numerator, then we have to take it in the denominator. If the term denominator have a negative term, then take it into the numerator. It means we have to change numerator to denominator or denominator to numerator. So if we change this, the numerator if nothing, it means it is 1. Then this term becomes positive, 1 raised to the power 1 by 3. We change the sign by taking it to the denominator. Now the term denominator is 3. How we have 5 cube. Cube of 5 is 125. So we can write as 5 cube. The whole power is 1 by 3. Power will be multiplied. 3 multiplied 1 by 3. 3 cancel out with 3. And what's the result? 1 upon 5 raised to the power 1, and 5 raised to the power 1 means 5. The answer is 1 by 5, not 5. So look at this question. Then we take our next question. Please make a note first. So now we have to take our next question. Question number is 3rd. What's the question 3rd is? Solve this. Please make a note. What's the rule? Law of exponent match with this property. Look at this. Base are same. If the base are same, power will be add. Again, if the base are same, power will be add. Okay. So please do. So we write the base as it is and power will be add. This one is 2 by 3 plus 1 by 5. Now we have to solve this. You can solve in rough work. 2 by 3 plus 1 by 5. What's the LCM 3 and 5? Which is equal to 15. Now solve this. Say 5 into 2, 10. 3 into 1, 13. Which is equal to 13 upon 15. Now put these values. Which is equal to 2 raised to the power 13 upon by 15, which one is your final answer. Now look at this. The second question. Here, numerator and denominator have the same base but different power. Then it will be subtract. If it is multiply, then will power will be add. And if it is form of divide, then it the power is subtract. So what we will put? 11 raised to the power 1 by 2 upper power minus lower power minus 1 by 4. Now solve this in the form, because 1 by 2 minus 1 by 4 LCM is 4. So 2 minus 1 we get 1 by 4. So your answer is 11 raised to the power 1 by 4. This one is your final answer. Now look at our third question. Power, the whole power. Firstly, if the terms have in terms of numerator and denominator, and the power is of the whole term. So firstly, we have to write the power of individual term as it is. So in this, we can written as 1 raised to the power 7 as it is, and 3 raised to the power 3, 7. We separate the term numerator as well as denominator by taking different powers. So we have changed numerator as well as denominator. Now 1 raised to the power 7 is always 1, because if we multiply 1 and so many times, we get only 1. Now this power into power, power will be multiplied. 3 raised to the power 3 into 7. What will be the answer? 3 raised to the power 3 into 2, 7. This is equal to 21. This will be your final answer. But you can also write in numerator. If we take 3 raised to the 21 in numerator, then its sign of the power will be changed. So another answer is 3 raised to the power minus 21. Both answers are correct. Now look at our fourth, third part. Now look at this. Power is same. If the power is same, base will be add. If the power is same, then base will be multiplied. So in this 7 multiplied 8, and power will be same. This is 56 to the power 1 raised to 1 by 2. So answer is your 56 raised to the power 1 by 2. If the power are same, base will be multiplied. So that's your answer. So this is exercise very simple and very short. So you can do it quickly. So this is as simple. If you like my video, don't forget to subscribe my channel, Gaurav Gupta Maths Classes. Then I will prepare our next topic. Soon you will get your next video. If you still not subscribe my channel, do subscribe so that you will get a notification whenever I upload a new video. So see you again.